If you need to create a CSV type file, and the simple with most Excel files, you can do a file save as. And you'll see there's a CSV option. But if it doesn't do what you want, you can create it from scratch. So let's say I don't want it separated by commas, I want it separated by semicolons. So the function we're going to use is the text join function. And you'll see the first thing is what is a delimiter. So let's say I need an inverted comma, a semicolon. So between inverted commas, I'm going to put a semicolon. Ignore empty. If I leave it blank and something like this happens, it'll actually ignore it as if it doesn't exist. That causes a problem with the CSV because this one will then have less columns than the other one. So I'm actually going to type false here. And then the text is as simple as highlighting that area. And when I say OK, you'll see it's got it. I can then copy it down as far as I need to. And if you look closely, you'll notice that here we've got two semicolons next to each other. That's for the blank. And when you get it to this stage, you can either work on it and do a file save as various versions, but we quite like, I'm going to copy it, go straight to Notepad, paste it, and then save it like that. And if you open it again, it'll actually come up in Excel and you'll be able to use that as a delimiter. The one problem with this is if you look closely, notice that the date here is not the same as the date there. And that's because what Excel has done is it knows that that date actually in Excel is the number 38,743. If, however, you need to actually see exactly what's there or another format, then the way we do it is I'd actually create this again. So I'm going to go, but now I'm going to use the text function. So I'm going to point at that date and in inverted commas, put it the way I want. So I know I want that format to stay, but I need to see it. So it's going to be YYYY/MM for month, /DD for day, close inverted commas. I'm going to say okay. So although it looks exactly the same, what you'll see is if I now do my text join, I'm going to do it slightly differently this time. So I'm going to do a text join, delimiter, I'm going to use between inverted commas is my semicolon, ignore empty, false, because I need it. The first text I want in there, I'm going to point at this cell. In the second text, I'm just going to highlight this area here, leaving out that first one. When I say OK, what you'll see is it creates the same thing as before, except now the date actually is recorded and left exactly as it is represented here. And again, you could then copy it, go to Notepad, and paste it. And then you'll see you've now got the date in the format you want, but separated by semicolons or whatever you need.